Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If 5 plus 3 square root of 2 to the power m equals 3 plus 5 times square root of 2 to the power n, here m and n are integers. The question is, what are the values of m and n? In this video, we are going to discuss a method called proof with contradiction to solve this question. From the given condition, we can see that both 5 plus 3 square root of 2 and 3 plus 5 square root of 2 are irrational numbers. First of all, we are going to derive a simple result. If number x equals a plus b times square root of 2. Number y equals c plus d times square root of 2. Here, a, b, c, d are positive integers. The two numbers are irrational numbers. We consider the product of the two numbers. Simplify this expression. We have here the real part of this product is also a positive number. The irrational part, the constants, is also a positive number, positive integer. Therefore, the product x times y is an irrational number too. We are going to use this result to solve our question. We can easily generalize the product to three numbers, four numbers, eight numbers. We have the same result. If all numbers have this kind of format, the product is an irrational number. The base 3 plus 5 square root of 2 is bigger than 1. The base 5 plus 3 square root of 2 is also bigger than 1. This implies the power m and n must have the same sign. If he has positive, he should be positive. Here it's negative, he should be negative. Why? If 1 is positive, 1 is negative, that means, for example, m is positive, this number, the left-hand side, is bigger than 1. If n is negative, the right-hand side is less than 1. It is impossible. So m and n must have the same sign. That means both negatives, both positives. We also can assume m is bigger than or equal to 0. N is bigger than or equal to 0. Why? If both m and n less than or equal to 0. From this result, we know that they have the same sign. If they are less than or equal to zero, we can see that this is a given condition. We can consider take negative 1 power on both sides. Then we have the following equation. The place of m now is negative n. The place of n now is negative n. Here, negative m is bigger than or equal to 0. Negative n is bigger than or equal to 0 because both m and n are less than or equal to 0. So here, we can replace m by negative m to discuss our question. Therefore, we can always assume m is bigger than or equal to 0, n is bigger than or equal to 0. Based on this assumption, we can easily find a simple solution, which is m equals 0 and n equals 0. Next thing we need to do is to find other solutions. We need to check if this solution is the only solution. If m is bigger than 1, n is bigger than or equal to 1. If both m and n are bigger than or equal to 1, what will happen? Why we can assume this way? Because we already discussed m equals 0, n equals 0, that's a solution. Now, bigger than 0. Bigger than 0, is that possible? M is bigger than or equal to 1, n is 0? No, because 5 plus 3 square root of 2, 3 plus 5 square root of 2, both are bigger than 1. If 1 is 0, it's 1. The other one is bigger than 0. The equal sign is not true. So this implies m must be bigger than or equal to 1, n at the same time is bigger than or equal to 1. Comparing the two bases, 3 plus 5 square root of 2 and 5 plus 3 square root of 2, which one is bigger? Consider the difference. Simplify, we can find square root of 2 is bigger than 1. This implies the final answer is bigger than 0. This means 3 plus 5 square root of 2 is bigger than 5 plus 3 square root of 2. What does this mean? Base is bigger, the power should be smaller. The base is smaller, the power should be bigger. Otherwise, the equal sign is not true. This implies m is bigger than n. If m is bigger than n, both sides of this given equation times negative 3 plus 5 square root of 2 to the power n. Check the right-hand side. Why are we doing this? The right-hand side is 5 square root of 2 plus 3. 5 square root of 2 minus 3. We use a difference formula of squares. It's 5 square root of 2, then square, minus 3 squared. The left-hand side, we have this one here, negative 3 plus 5 square root of 2 to the power n. Originally, this 5 plus 3 square root of 2 to the power n, we can split the second term into two parts. Same base here. the power is m minus n. Here is n. N plus m minus n is m. We simplify the product of the first two terms. Simplify this part again. And this part has 50 minus 9 equals 51 to the power n. Simplify this part, we have 15 plus 16 square root of n to the power n. Based on our simple result, this number is irrational. To the power n, still irrational. 5 plus 3 square root of 2 to the power m minus n. M minus n is bigger than or equal to 1, not 0. So this number is irrational. Use the same simple result, then consider irrational times irrational, or a, b, c, d are positive integer. This implies the left-hand side is irrational. So 41 to the power n is rational. From the right-hand side, from the left-hand side, this number is irrational number. Is that possible? No, it is impossible. What does that mean? That means m and n only can be zero. M equals n equals zero is the only answer. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.